Chapter 48 Of Moab. Thus says the Lord of armies, the God of Israel, Woe to Nebo, for it is laid waste. Kiriathaim is disappointed, it is taken. Mizgab is put to shame and broken down. The praise of Moab is no more. In Heshbon they have devised evil against her. Come and let us cut her off from being a nation. You also, madmen, shall be brought to silence. The sword shall pursue you. The sound of a cry from Horonaim, desolation and great destruction. Moab is destroyed. Her little ones have caused a cry to be heard. For by the ascent of Luhith, with continual weeping shall they go up. For at the descent of Horonaim they have heard the distress of the cry of desolation. Flee, save your lives, and be like the heath in the wilderness. For because you have trusted in your works and in your treasures, you also shall be taken. Chemosh shall go forth into captivity, his priest and his princes together. The destroyer shall come on every city, and no city shall escape. The valley also shall perish, and the plain shall be destroyed, as the Lord has spoken. Give wings to Moab, that she may fly and get her away, and her cities become a desolation, without any to dwell therein. Cursed be he who does the work of the Lord negligently, and cursed be he who keeps back his sword from blood. Moab has been at ease from his youth, and he has settled on his lees, and has not been emptied from vessel to vessel, neither has he gone into captivity. Therefore his taste remains in him, and his scent is not changed. Therefore, behold, the days come, says the Lord, that I will send to him those who pour off, and they shall pour him off, and they shall empty his vessels, and break their bottles in pieces. Moab shall be ashamed of Chemosh, as the house of Israel was ashamed of Bethel, their confidence. How do you say, We are mighty men and valiant for the war? Moab is laid waste, and they are gone up into his cities, and his chosen young men are gone down to the slaughter, says the king, whose name is the Lord of armies. The calamity of Moab is near to come, and his affliction hurries fast. All you who are round about him bemoan him, and all you who know his name say, How is the strong staff broken, the beautiful rod? You daughter who dwells in Dibon, come down from your glory and sit in thirst, for the destroyer of Moab has come up against you. He has destroyed your strongholds. Inhabitant of Aroer, stand by the way and watch. Ask him who flees and her who escapes. Say, what has been done? Moab is disappointed, for it is broken down. Wail and cry. Tell by the Arnon that Moab is laid waste. Judgment has come on the plain country, on Holon, and on Jazah, and on Mephath, and on Dibon, and on Nebo, and on Beth Diblathaim, and on Kiriathaim, and on Beth Gamul, and on Beth Meon, and on Kirioth, and on Bosra, and on all the cities of the land of Moab, far or near. The horn of Moab is cut off, and his arm is broken, says the Lord. Make him drunken, for he magnified himself against the Lord, and Moab shall wallow in his vomit, and he shall also be in derision. For wasn't Israel a derision to you? Was he found among thieves? For as often as you speak of him, you wag the head. You inhabitants of Moab, leave the cities and dwell in the rock, and be like the dove that makes her nest over the mouth of the abyss. We have heard of the pride of Moab, that he is very proud, his loftiness and his pride, and his arrogance and the haughtiness of his heart. I know his wrath, says the Lord, that it is nothing. His boastings have worked nothing. Therefore will I wail for Moab. Yes, I will cry out for all Moab. For the men of Kirjerez shall they mourn. With more than the weeping of Jazir will I weep for you, vine of Sibmah. Your branches passed over the sea. They reached even to the sea of Jazir. On your summer fruits and on your vintage the destroyer is fallen. Gladness and joy is taken away from the fruitful field and from the land of Moab, and I have caused wine to cease from the wine presses. None shall tread with shouting, the shouting shall be no shouting. From the cry of Heshbon, even to Aleah, even to Jahaz they have uttered their voice, from Zoar, even to Horonaim, to Egleth-Shelishiah, for the waters of Nimrin also shall become desolate. Moreover, I will cause to cease in Moab, says the Lord, him who offers in the high places, and him who burns incense to his gods. Therefore my heart sounds for Moab like pipes, and my heart sounds like pipes for the men of Kir-Hares. Therefore the abundance that he has gotten is perished. For every head is bald, and every beard clipped. On all the hands are cuttings, and on the loins sackcloth. On all the housetops of Moab and in the streets of it there is lamentation everywhere. For I have broken Moab like a vessel in which none delights, says the Lord. How is it broken down? How do they wail? How has Moab turned the back with shame? So shall Moab become a derision and a terror to all who are round about him. For thus says the Lord, behold, he shall fly as an eagle, and shall spread out his wings against Moab. Kerioth is taken, and the strongholds are seized, and the heart of the mighty men of Moab at that day shall be as the heart of a woman in her pangs. Moab shall be destroyed from being a people, because he has magnified himself against the Lord. Fear and the pit and the snare are on you, inhabitant of Moab, says the Lord. He who flees from the fear shall fall into the pit, and he who gets up out of the pit shall be taken in the snare. For I will bring on him, even on Moab, the year of their visitation, says the Lord. Those who fled stand without strength under the shadow of Heshbon. For a fire is gone out of Heshbon, and a flame from the midst of Shihon, and has devoured the corner of Moab, and the crown of the head of the tumultuous ones. Woe to you, O Moab! The people of Chemosh is undone, for your sons are taken away captive, and your daughters into captivity. Yet I will bring back the captivity of Moab in the latter days, says the Lord. Thus far is the judgment of Moab.